Welcome. Today we will have the first tutorial of module 5, that is heat integration of the process. We shall see problems on determination of the minimum hot and cold utility requirement, plotting of the composite curve, determination of the pinch temperatures, and then calculation of the area in a heat integration interval. Let me give statement of the first problem that we are going to see today. The stream data for a certain process is as follows. There are two hot streams and two cold streams plus a hot utility and cold utility. So, the stream number and type, then the supply temperature, degree centigrade, the target temperature, degree centigrade, the heat capacity flow rate, in megawatt per degree centigrade, and then the heat transfer coefficient. In watt per meter square per degree centigrade. Okay. So, the data is stream 1, it is a hot stream, the supply temperature is 400 degree centigrade, target temperature is 60, the heat capacity flow rate is 0.3 megawatt per degree centigrade, heat transfer coefficient that we denote by H is 600. Second stream is also hot stream, here the supply temperature is 210, the target temperature is 40 degrees centigrade, heat capacity flow rate 0.5, and heat transfer coefficient of 1000 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. Then third stream is cold stream, the supply temperature is 20, target temperature is 160, heat capacity flow rate 0.4, and heat transfer coefficient 800. Fourth stream is also a cold stream, supply temperature 100, target temperature 300, heat capacity flow rate 0.6, and heat transfer coefficient 800. The hot utility is steam. Hot utility we denote by HU. Steam is at temperature of 240 degrees centigrade and the target temperature is 239. We do not take any subcooling there, and the heat transfer coefficient is 3000 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. And then the cold utility is cooling water. It comes at 20 degrees centigrade and leaves at 30 degrees centigrade, and its heat transfer coefficient is 1000 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. Now, we have to answer three questions based on this stream data. First is that using problem tables cascade, determine the minimum hot utility and minimum cold utility. Minimum hot utility is denoted by acronym QHmin, and minimum cold utility by QC min. And then we are given a delta T min, pinch temperature difference of 10 degrees centigrade. Okay. Now we have to answer another question here. For the given supply and target temperature, of hot utility and cold utility, what are the heat capacity flow rates that are required. Then the second question that we have to answer is a modified form. Like here we are given delta T min equal to 20 degree centigrade. So same thing, using problem table cascade, determine QH min and QC min for delta T equal to delta T min of 20 degree centigrade, and again here we have to calculate the heat capacity flow rates. Calculate the required heat capacity flow rates of the two utilities. And the third question that we have to answer is about plotting the composite curve. For hot and cold streams, on the temperature enthalpy diagram or TH diagram, and determine the pinch temperatures for the two streams. For delta T min of 20 degree centigrade. So let us start the solution. The first question is determination of QH min and QC min at delta T equal to 10 degree centigrade. For this purpose, we first shift the temperatures of the streams. We first write the shifted temperatures. We have to shift or lower the temperature of the hot stream by delta T min by 2 or 5 degrees centigrade, and increase the temperature of cold stream by again same value, delta T min by 2 is equal to 5 degrees. So the shifted temperatures of the streams are as follows. Stream 1 . It is a hot stream. Supply temperature that we denote by TS degree centigrade is 400 minus 5, so 395. The target temperature is 60 minus 5, that is 55. Okay. Then second stream, which is also a hot stream, here the supply temperature was 210, that is lowered by 5 degrees to 205. Target temperature was 40, that is again lowered by 5 degrees to 35. The third stream is a cold stream. Here the supply temperature was 20, which is increased by 5 degrees, so 25. And the target temperature was 160, that is increased by 5 to 165. Same, the fourth stream is also a cold stream. Here the supply temperature was 100. So that is shifted to 105, and the target temperature was 300, that is shifted to 305. The heat capacity flow rates, however, remain the same. I note down here the heat capacity flow rates for convenience. स्टीम 1.3, स्ट्रीम 2.5, स्ट्रीम 3.4 एंड स्ट्रीम 4.6. यस, नाउ वी हैव टू प्लॉट द स्ट्रीम पॉपुलेशन डेटा. Here we give the first the interval temperature. We have to identify various intervals of temperature and then mark the streams. The highest temperature is 395, thereafter 305, thereafter 205, thereafter 165, then 105, 55, 35 and 25. Now delta T interval in degrees centigrade in the first temperature interval 395 to 305, so 90 degrees. Then 305 to 205, that is 100 degrees. And then we can write the further intervals. I am giving the values now directly. And now we have to mark the streams in this temperature interval. The first stream goes from 395 to 55. It has a Cp value of 0.3, so that I write besides the stream. Then stream 2 goes from 205 to 35. It has a Cp of 0.5, that again we write side at the side. The third stream goes from 25 to 165. It has a Cp of 0.4. And the fourth stream goes from 105 to 305. It has a Cp of 0.6. Now, in each of the temperature interval, we have to calculate the sum of the heat capacity flow rates of cold stream minus the sum of heat capacity flow rates of hot streams, summation CPC minus summation CPH, and this is again megawatt per degree centigrade. So here in the first interval, there is only stream 1. So it has a heat capacity of 0.3, but it is hot stream, so minus 0.3. In the second interval, again it is the only stream, so there also we have, no, in the second interval we have two streams, stream 1 which has a Cp of 0.3 and stream 4 which has a Cp of 0.6. So the summation CPC minus summation CPH is 0.6 minus 0.3, that is 0.3. plus 0.3. And you go further, now I am giving values directly. In each interval, like for example, in the interval between 165 to 105, we have all four streams, two hot streams and two cold streams. Summation CPC is 0.4 plus 0.6, that is 1, and summation CPH is 0.3 plus 0.5, that is 0.8. So 1 minus 0.8 is plus 0.2. And similarly, you can go ahead, I am giving directly values. Now we have to calculate the delta H in the interval, that is in megawatt, and it can be obtained by multiplication of delta T interval to summation CPC minus summation CPH. Okay. So first interval माइनस 0.3 इंटू 90 दैट इज माइनस 27, देन प्लस 0.3 इंटू 100 दैट इज प्लस 30, देन नेक्स्ट इज 40 इंटू माइनस 0.2 इज माइनस 8 एंड देन यू कैन गो अहेड. And now we have to determine whether we have a supply or deficit of the heat in that particular interval. Negative delta H means there is surplus heat and positive delta H means there is deficit of it. So in the first interval we have excess, so it is plus 27. In the second interval, it is 27 minus 30, so minus 3, then minus 3 minus minus 8, so plus 5, then 5 minus 12, that is minus 7, then minus 7 minus minus 20, that is plus 13, then 13 minus minus 2, that is plus 15, and 15 minus 4, that is plus 11. Now here we can see is that the maximum deficit that we have is in the fourth interval, the interval between 165 and 105, and that is minus 7. So now if we add a hot utility worth that much heat in the first interval, then the net deficit or surplus becomes 0 and that balances the whole streams, the heat balance in the streams, enthalpy balance. So we add 7 megawatt of hot utility, then 7 plus 20, see this 7 add to the 27 available in the second interval, so that becomes 34. Then out of this 34 we take off 30, the second, so only 4 remain. Then to this 4 we add minus 8 of the fourth interval, so that becomes plus 12, and then 12 minus 12 becomes 0 here. So here you have a pinch, and then further the next interval has minus 20, so the net utility available or heat available is 20 megawatt, then out of which again in the next interval you have minus 2, okay, so that again adds to 22, and to that, from this 22 we have to supply 4 megawatt in the last interval, so that is we are left with 18 megawatt. Okay, therefore we see that we are left with 18 megawatt of heat finally, which we have to remove with cold utility. So, the minimum hot utility requirement, thus minimum hot utility requirement of the process is 7 megawatt, while the minimum cold utility requirement is 18 megawatt. So that is the answer. Now we have to also determine the heat capacity flow rates that are required of the two utilities. The heat capacity flow rates is the QH min or QC min divided by the temperature interval of that particular utility. For steam, which is hot utility, we have supply of 240 and target of 239, so that gives delta T equal to 1 degree centigrade. And for cooling water, which is cold utility, we have supply of 20 degrees centigrade, target of 30, so that gives delta T equal to 10 degrees centigrade. And therefore, the heat capacity flow rate of hot utility is 7 by 1 which is equal to 7 megawatt per degree centigrade, and cold utility heat capacity flow rate is 18 by 10, that is 1.8 megawatt per degree centigrade. That completes the first bit of the problem. Now, in the second bit, we have to repeat the same thing for delta T min equal to 20 degree centigrade. So, now here I will leave most of the things to you because it is rather straightforward exercise with delta T min equal to 20 degree centigrade. I will give only the answers. Here we have to shift the temperatures. By delta T min by 2, that is 10 degree centigrade. So, the supply and target shifted temperature interval becomes steam 1 shifted temperature that we denote by T S star, and T T shifted temperature interval by T T star. So, the supply was at 350, so that becomes 340. So the supply was at 400, so that becomes 390. Then target was 60, so that becomes 50, shifting by 10 degrees. Then similarly for other streams, we can write the temperatures. Now, next is the stream population data. Here we have interval temperature. We have now highest temperature 390, then 310, 200, 170, 110, 50 and 30, and then the stream population. First stream goes from 390 to 50. With Cp of 0.3, the second stream goes from 200 to 50 . The third stream goes from 30 degrees to 170, and the fourth stream goes from 110 to 310. The Cp values we write besides the stream: 0.5 for 2, 0.4 for 3, 0.6 for 4. Now, delta T interval in degree centigrade is 80, this is 110, then 30, 60, 60 and 20. Then next is summation CPC minus summation CPH. here again this remains same as previous, minus 0.3 plus 0.3 minus 0.2 plus 0.2 minus 0.4 and minus 0.1. Then we have to calculate the delta H in the interval minus 24, minus 33, minus 6, 12, minus 24, minus 2, and then surplus deficit of heat. So in the first interval we have plus 24, then minus 9, 33 taken off, then minus 3, minus 15, 9 and 11. And thus we see here is that the maximum deficit is in the fifth interval of minus 15 megawatt. So that much hot utility we have to add to the first interval. So 15, then 39. After hot utility addition, the cumulative delta H in each interval is 15 megawatt in the first, then 15 plus 15 minus minus 24, so 39, then 39 minus 33, that is 6, 6 minus minus 6, 12, then here it becomes 0, 12 minus 12, and then 9, this is minus 24, so plus 24, and 24 minus minus 2, that is 26. So here we need a hot utility requirement for this case is 15 megawatt, and then after supplying of 15 megawatt, we are left with 26 megawatt of surplus heat, which we have to discard to cold utility. So cold utility requirement is 26 megawatt. Now the heat capacity flow rates are for hot utility 15 megawatt divided by 1 degrees, so 15 megawatt per degree centigrade, and for cold utility it is 26 megawatt by 10 degrees, so 2.6 megawatt per degree centigrade. So that completes the second problem. Now in the third bit we have to plot the composite curve. Here we have to calculate the cumulative enthalpy of different streams. Okay. Now we have total 3 hot streams and 3 cold streams, out of which 2 are process and one is utility each. Now here we give the direct temperature interval. The highest temperature is 400, 300, thereafter 240, 239 of steam, thereafter 210, 160, 100, 60, 40, 30 and 20. Now again we have to give the stream data here, the 3 hot streams are, or let us say first we start the cold streams, stream population. The third cold stream goes from 20 degrees. Let us see the third bit of the problem, plot of composite curve for delta T min equal to 10 degrees centigrade. Now here we have to calculate, delta T mean of 20 degrees centigrade, not 10 degrees centigrade. Okay, delta T mean of 20 degrees centigrade. So here what we do is that first we calculate the cumulative enthalpy of the hot streams and the cold stream, that is the composite curve. Okay. So here again we make a temperature stream population diagram. The highest temperature is 400, then 300, then 240, 239. So we basically list all the temperatures in the process in the decreasing order, and then we plot the streams in that particular temperature interval. So let us start with the cold streams first. Okay. Stream 3 goes from 20 degrees to 160 degrees and it has a Cp of 0.4. Then stream 4 goes from 100 degrees to 300 degrees and it has a Cp of 0.6, and the cold utility goes from 20 degrees to 30 degrees, and as we just calculated, it has a Cp of 2.6 megawatt. Okay. Now, let us calculate the delta H of the composite stream. Okay. We assume here that the least temperature of the cold stream is 20 degrees. So that we take as a reference temperature, and then we assume the delta H, the enthalpy of the composite curve, to be zero at that reference temperature. Now, as long as the number of streams in a particular temperature interval or succeeding temperature interval remain constant, we will have a straight line of the composite curve. Whenever there is addition or deletion of any stream, then the slope of that particular curve will change. Now, let us see the first interval. Okay. We assume for cold streams enthalpy to be 0 at 20 degrees centigrade. Okay. So between 20 and 30 we have two streams, the third stream and cold utility, and together they have a heat capacity of 2.6 plus 0.4, that is 3 megawatt per degree centigrade, and the temperature interval is 10 degrees. So at 30 degrees we have the net total enthalpy, composite enthalpy of cold streams as 30 megawatt. Now, between 30 to 60, we say that there is only one stream, that is the third stream with 0.4 heat capacity. And then at 100 degrees centigrade, we again calculate, because between 30 and 100, there is only one stream. Okay, so we will not have any change of slope, and therefore from 30 to 100, that is 70 plus 70 into 0.4, that is 28, and plus 30, that is 58. So at 100 degrees centigrade, the total enthalpy of the cold composite curve will be 58 megawatt. From 100 degrees centigrade, stream 4 adds, okay, and then till 160, we have two streams, number 3 and 4. So again, we have to calculate the enthalpy at 160 degrees centigrade. Okay. The temperature interval from 100 to 160 is 60 degrees, and the total Cp is 0.4 plus 0.6, that is 1. So to 58, we add 60, okay, 60 into 1, that is 118. And then from 160 onwards, we have only one stream, okay, that is the number 4 stream. And then it goes up to 300 degrees centigrade with a temperature interval of 140, and it has a Cp of 0.6. So that again adds 84 megawatt, and then the total becomes here at 300 degrees centigrade, 202 megawatt. Okay. Yeah. So that is the enthalpy temperature data for the cold composite curve. Similarly for hot composite curve. First of all, we have to give the stream population. I am extending the temperature interval lines. Now, we have the first hot stream, number 1 stream, going from temperature 400 degrees 400 degrees to 60 degrees. Then we have number 2 stream going from 210 to 40 degrees. Then hot utility from 240 to 239. Number 1 stream has CP of 0.3, number 2 stream has CP of 0.5, and hot utility has a CP of 15. Now we have to calculate delta H for the hot composite stream. Here the least temperature is 40 degrees, so we take 40 degree as a reference temperature and assume zero enthalpy here, okay, and then again do the same way as we did before, that we check where till what temperature range the stream population is remaining constant. So till that point the composite curve will have same slope. So here we see that for temperature intervals 40 to 60 there is only one stream, that is number 2. 60 onwards the number 1 stream adds. So at 60 degrees the total cumulative enthalpy is 0.5 into 20, that is 10. Then till 210 temperature there are two streams, number 1 and number 2, and together they have CP of 0.8. okay, so we add from 60 to 210, okay, so 150 degrees interval into 0.8, okay, so 120 megawatt. So the total cumulative enthalpy at 210 degrees is 130. Then between 210 and 239 there are two streams, okay, number 1 and number 2. So the cumulative enthalpy at 239 is 138.7. So 0.3 plus 0.5 into 29, so that is what we have added. And finally we have at 240 degrees the hot utility. So up to 240 there are two streams again, hot utility 15 megawatt per degree centigrade, number 1 stream with 0.3, so 15.3 into 1, okay, so that is 15.3, and that we add, so this becomes 154 cumulative enthalpy. And in the last interval from 240 to 400 we have only one stream, number 1 stream with CP of 0.3, so that is 160 into 0.3, okay, so that we get another 48 megawatt, so that cumulative becomes 202. So then we can see here that this is a completely balanced curve. The total cumulative enthalpy of cold stream and total cumulative enthalpy of hot streams is exactly the same. And now we have to plot the temperature versus H data, cumulative H data for hot composite stream and cold composite stream, and that graph I am showing you now. What you see on the screen is the composite curve for delta T min equal to 20 degrees centigrade, and then we have to find out the pinch. Here we can see that the pinch occurs at 120 degrees centigrade for the hot stream and 100 degrees centigrade for the cold composite stream. So here you have one pinch, okay. There is another pinch also seen here at 240 and 220, okay. So here we have basically two pinches, okay. One pinch is at 120 and 100, and another pinch is at 240 and 220. So that point we note here. After plotting of HTH data, that is composite curves, we find two pinches. One pinch at T hot 120 and T cold 100 degrees centigrade, and second pinch at T hot equal to 240 degrees centigrade, and T cold as 220 degrees centigrade. Okay, so that completes the third bit of the problem.
The next question is on enthalpy intervals. Then the problem statement appears on your screen. For heat exchange stream data, same as the previous question, calculate the target for network heat transfer area for delta T minimum equal to 10 degrees centigrade.
We have earlier done calculation for determination of QH min and QC min for delta T min equal to 10 degrees centigrade. So we make use of that answer for this question. We have been given a formula for heat exchanger area in an enthalpy interval. Enthalpy interval K, the area in it AK is 1 by delta T LM into the bracket summation QI by HI for all hot streams plus summation QJ by HJ for all cold streams. The notations are given. QI is the stream duty on hot stream I in an enthalpy interval K. QJ is the stream duty on cold stream J in enthalpy interval K. HI and HJ are film coefficients for hot and cold streams. We have to answer here again two questions. First, plot the enthalpy intervals for balanced composite curve showing the different enthalpy intervals for delta T min equal to 10 degrees centigrade. And secondly, we have to develop the network area target table indicating LMTD summation Q by H for hot and cold streams and the heat exchanger area for the enthalpy intervals. We start with the first bit, that is plotting of the composite curves and identification of the enthalpy intervals. Now, what you see on the screen is the enthalpy interval data. We have listed all the temperatures in the process in descending order. Then we have also listed the stream population, like stream, we have two hot streams, 3 and 4. Number 3 stream goes from 20 degrees to 160 degrees with Cp value of 0.4, and then number 4 stream goes from 100 to 300 with Cp value of 0.6. For cold streams, the minimum temperature is 20 degrees, so we take that as basis for calculation of composite enthalpy. So, 0 enthalpy at 20 degrees centigrade, and then at interval 20 to 30 we have 2 streams, 3 and cold streams, and the total enthalpy at 30 degrees is 22. Between 22 and 100, we have only one stream, that is stream 3, and then the enthalpy at 100 degrees centigrade is 50. Between 100 and 160, we have two streams, 3 and 4, and the enthalpy at 160 is 110. And from 160 to 300, we have only stream 4, and the total enthalpy at 300 degrees centigrade is 194. Similarly, we go for hot streams. We have two hot streams, 1 and 2. And one hot utility, and the minimum temperature for hot streams is 40 degrees centigrade. So we take that as basis, 0 enthalpy at 40 degrees centigrade, and then we list the enthalpies for different intervals. And when we plot these temperature versus enthalpy, we get the TH diagram or composite enthalpy interval diagram, okay? Composite curve diagram. Now what you see is identification of different enthalpy intervals. Like the first interval is here between 400 for hot composite stream to 240, then 240 to 239. Okay, whenever the composite curve changes its slope, either hot and cold, that is one enthalpy interval. So together we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the longest interval, 6, 7 and 8 enthalpy intervals. 8 times either the hot composite stream or cold composite stream changes its slope. That means the number of streams in that interval changes. Okay? Either one stream adds or one gets deleted, and therefore the slope changes. So we have identified a total 8 enthalpy intervals. We shall list these now by vertical lines. The first interval, 400 for hot composite stream, 300 for cold composite stream. Then 240 for hot, 220 corresponding temperature for cold, then 239. This is the 240 to 239 is the interval where hot utility adds. So above 240 hot utility is not there, below 239 also it is not there. So the corresponding temperature is 208. 210, here you can see this 210, this temperature, this interval we are at, and the corresponding cold composite temperature is 192, then 186, 160, 110, then 100, this is a pinch, 76, 76, and corresponding temperature is 30, then 60, corresponding temperature is 24, and 40, and corresponding temperature is 20. In this enthalpy intervals, we shall list all the streams. Like stream 1 is in all the intervals but the last. So, enthalpy interval 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So, number 1 stream is in interval 1 to 7. Similarly, number 2 stream is from 4 to 8. I will also write above it its Cp value and the value of H, the film coefficient. H is being written in megawatt per degree centigrade. Hot utility is between 240 to 239, Cp value of 7, H of 0.003, then the cold. Number 3 stream goes from 8th to 5th interval, Cp value 0.4, H 0.0008, 800 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. Then number 4 stream goes from 400 to 300, here Cp is 0.6, H is 800 watt per meter square per degree centigrade or 0.008 megawatt. Then cold utility goes from 20 to 30 degrees. Here Cp value is 1.8, we have already determined it in the previous example, and H value is 0.001 or 1000 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. Now with this stream population data, enthalpy interval data, we have to tabulate the network target, okay, heat exchanger area targets or targets for interval. Now let us take interval 1. Interval 1 has only one hot stream, as you see here. The temperature difference is 400 to 240, so 160. Heat duty is 160 into 0.3, the heat capacity, divided by, now we are calculating summation Q by H. So, Q is 160 into 0.3, H is 0.0006, so that turns out to be 80,000. Okay. Cold streams. Cold streams we have in the first interval only the fourth stream, okay, number 4 stream. It goes from 220 to 300, so 80 degrees difference, Cp value of 0.6, so that we note here, 80 into 0.6, and its H is 800 watt per meter square per degree centigrade or 0.008, so this is 60,000 summation Q by H. And then delta T Lm, delta T Lm for interval 1 we have 400 degrees centigrade entry temperature for hot composite and 300 degrees exit temperature for cold composite. So delta T at one end or left end is 400 minus 300. Similarly, we have 240 and 220, 240 exit temperature of hot stream, 220 entry temperature of cold stream. So 240 minus 220 divided by ln of 400 minus 300 divided by 240 minus 220. So this turns out to be 49.7. So that point we note here, 49.7. And then using the formula that we are given, A is equal to 1 by delta T Lm summation Q by H hot plus summation Q by H cold, we get area as, so that I will show you the exact calculation. Area is 1 by delta T Lm summation Q by H hot plus summation Q by H cold. We have all the values, delta T Lm 49.7 we just determined, plus 80,000 plus 60,000 summation Q by H for hot and cold. And area thus turns out to be 281.7 meter square. Okay. So that point we note here. Similarly, for second interval, we have first stream and hot stream, hot utility. So that for hot utility, temperature difference is 1, Cp of 7, H of 0.003. Similarly, for number 1 stream, Cp of 0.3, 0.006, and then this turns out to be 500 plus 2333. The cold streams that are there in the second interval is only one stream, number 4 stream, okay, and then the temperature difference in for that interval is 220 minus 208, that is 12 degrees. Okay, so 12 into 0.6, the Cp value, divided by 0.0008, the H of stream 4. So this is 9000. The delta T Lm we can calculate in similar way as I have shown you, as 25.1, and area is 471.4. Okay. So I am now giving you directly the answers for the other in intervals. I leave the calculation to you. Okay. Number 3 interval, 29 into 0.3, 0.006, 14,500. Then here 16 into 0.06. Number 4 stream is there. Okay. In interval, 12,000. Delta T Lm 23.91, area 1108.3. Number 4, we have two streams here, number 1 and number 2 stream. The temperature difference is 24. So, summation Q by H, and this is total 12,000 each. Cold streams available is only number 4, temperature difference is 32 degrees, H value is 800 watt per meter square per degree centigrade, So this is 24,000 Q by H, summation Q by H. Delta TLM is 21.76 and area is 2205.8. And similarly, you can carry out the other intervals. The total area, I leave it as an exercise. So this completes the first tutorial of the module of heat integration of the process. In the next tutorial, we shall see the design of heat exchanger network, that is coupling between the streams using the pinch technology. Okay. Thank you.